They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, pop up, trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging. Moving careful every day is exactly how I play this. Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I'm placing.
We are about 15 or so miles northwest of world-famous Miami Beach as we are set for football at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami Gardens. This crowd a few minutes ago stirred into action at the side of their Dolphins emerging from the Hard Rock Stadium tunnels, and we are ready to go. Let's get set to match up with the New York Giants. This will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. So they fake the handoff. Now Allen steps away. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away, and that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
I may be an analyst, but I'm also a fan. I love it when people take the big shots downfield, but he was under a lot of duress, and I think that forced the incompletion downfield. Didn't have a real good chance to find his target.
And this Giants defense getting off the ball quickly. They stop him behind the line again.
The job of any linebacker involves having enough strength to fight off a blocker and get to ball carriers. But in this case, I think we can safely say he beat him right off the snap to get into the backfield and make that play.
And past the 40 before he's out of bounds.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe-tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
Allen now on first down, out to his left, and that's incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Allen off the play fake. Open man is Jacob Hollister. And he's able to get this down deep on the Giants' side of the field. It's a big play there for Miami.
Things are looking pretty darn good on this first drive, aren't they? Came right out, set the tone, this time with a big pass play.
And if the peek behind the curtain that they gave us for their game plan, I don't think that's going to be the last one we see.
I think you're exactly right about that.
So after the big play, look at this, all the way down at the 15 now on first and 10. Handoff here to Nwangu. He will push his way down to about the 14. The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. On the give is Nwangu. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up third down. To throw, it's Allen. They'll roll him out right. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4.
Now that's disappointing for the defense. They had the advantage, had excellent coverage all over the field, but they let him get away, scramble, and pick up a first down and inside the 5-yard line.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. To the air, Allen. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. Henry Ruggs there to make the grab. And the Dolphins are on the board here first in the season opener. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game.
PAT in his rearview mirror. He goes back out to kick this one off.
This will be fielded inside the five.
Oh, a good-looking return set up here.
And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33.
Jones and the Giants now with a first and 10 at the 33-yard line.
Ladies college ball in Tallahassee. Here's Cam Akers.
And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
To throw on second and six, Jones.
And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up third down.
I think that's how this defense is going to need to play these tight ends. Again, get right up on them and stay physical. And that paid off on that play, helping force that incompletion.
Throwing, Jones. And the throw there going to be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
It is one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
And Bohorquez on to punt as he gets it away.
This is taken at about the 14.
13 yards, the tally on the return there.
And it'll be Dolphin football. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And certainly they'll be hoping to hit pay dirt like they did on the last drive. Got the football back, so a chance to go up two scores.
And they haven't been tentative at all in this ball game, because sometimes you start a game with your script to try and get information out of the opposing defense. How will they play you in certain situations? Sometimes you script to attack. And that's what I'm seeing so far.
They'll buy some time right.
Open man is Quintez Cephas.
And they've got it well across midfield down to the 40 before it's all said and done.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass in the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
A really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw. When they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations, ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. On play action, Allen. Sliding out of the pocket. Letting one go deep for the end zone. And oh, it'll be intercepted. It's Chuck Clark picking it off.
And the Giants are going to have the football here at their own 18-yard line.
They exited the pocket trying to improvise. That was a tough throw, and unfortunately, it wound up in the wrong pair of hands.
And Brandon, when you're on the run, sometimes your downfield vision can get skewed just a bit. Now, the beauty of extending a play is sometimes your receivers find their way open, but oftentimes you end up closing down part of the field and bringing those defenders to the ball, and that one was picked off.
Working with a second and four.
Now Jones.
That's out to the flat for Akers.
And some room to run now. And he'll be marked down deep on Miami's side of the field. A big play there on the catch and run.
Well, and this is where quarterbacks' passing numbers sometimes get a little bit more inflated than they should, because this is a short little pass, but it goes for big yardage.
They'll run on first down with Akers. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
To throw on second and six, Jones buying time to his left. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
On third down, Jones.
And this pass broken up.
Well, the contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
And that is going to be no good. He pushed it wide to the right, and this score will stay right where it is. So they'll come away with nothing here. A disappointing result even on a day like this.
And as a kicker in the rain, you've got to slow things down a little bit. Give your holder an extra half second to make sure everything's secure. And here, he might have rushed this one a little, and it winds up no good.
They'll start on the ground here with Nwangu. And he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up three on that carry.
Now a nice throw here right side. He hauls it in. John Ross, 76 yards. And the Dolphins strike quickly here for 6 points. Sam Sloman for the PAT. And we'll see if this rain affects the team's decisions going forward, but they kick it here, and it's good. 13-0 is the score after one on EA Sports. Out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. It hasn't gone particularly well for them, that's obvious. In these conditions, no points so far. They've got to get that offense on track. The question, how do they do it?
It is the age-old question, isn't it? And to me, finding a way to make sure your playmakers touch the ball without it being too exotic. Meaning you don't have to go deep down the field. Maybe you hit them on those short passes on the perimeter. Make sure you just turn around.
The Dolphins get there this time. It'll go as a loss of about six, and now it brings up third. After that sack, third and long. Tough spot for Jones and the Giants to throw on third down. Jones toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge, and that's good enough for a first down. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw, eluding the pressure right. They'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down. Looking to throw, Jones. That's complete to the fullback, Ricard.
Well, this has certainly been a nice drive with the way they've spread the football around. Here, they even get the fullback involved in the passing game. That's got to cause a lot of consternation on the defensive side. You got to cover him, too. That makes things really difficult.
Oh, he'll let one go deep for Higgins. And this incomplete. An excellent play downfield on the football. Might have had a shot to pick it off even. But it's second down. Here's a run with Akers on second down. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled them up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
Here's the seventh play of this drive. This is third and four. Back to throw. Jones escaping the pressure right. Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36.
Well, you're already up a couple of scores here in the first half defensively, and Charles, they just seem to be playing really free on that side of the football.
I love the observation because with that type of a lead, they feel like they can take a few more chances and be even more aggressive, and it's been paying off for them so far this game.
And he's brought down. Can't do anything with the football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. The Giants go on fourth but come up empty. And the Dolphins defense is able to hold. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And thus far, the weather has not slowed this offense down one bit. They've looked good so far in the first half.
They certainly have. And think back to our meeting with the head coach. And we asked him because we saw the forecast for this game, didn't we? We said, hey, have you prepared for this? And he talked about the different drills that they've done in adverse conditions, the wet ball drills, things of that nature. He said, I don't think it's going to slow us down much.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted.
Picked off by Keon Crossan,
and he's just across midfield and down at the 49-yard line. You don't see this often, a quarterback of his caliber, two first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, David.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off. I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right? Now a throw here to his running back. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. Jones from the gun, he'll throw. And he's got it. Touchdown, Giants. Cam Akers there to make the grab. And the Giants have got it back to a one-score game. The Giant offense going to stay on the field as they'll go for two. Jones throwing. And now the pressure gets there, and he goes down. So he couldn't get rid of the football, and that deficit stays right where it is. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. From just inside the 20, a short kick. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. On play action, Allen rolling to his right. And this one taken in by Cephas. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And partner, they're locked in man coverage out left, and they end up running a crossing route. Rounded it a little bit more than a slant. And he's just going to angle himself towards the right side of the field, and that's very difficult for a defender to shadow him across all that ground.
A reminder, coming up at halftime, we'll send you up to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman is there, and he'll have stats and scores from a busy Sunday in the NFL. Steps away to his left, and he'll just get rid of it.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
On second and 10, Allen flush to his right. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets it down to the 30 there.
looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit, because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into his windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception, really a bad throw, so maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
That'll go for a gain of 7, and it'll bring up a second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
On second down, here's DeWongu. And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage. 7th play of the drive now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. Play action. Now it's Allen. Flushed out right. And Allen going to be intercepted for the 3rd time. Picked off at the 17.
I think that interception happened for 2 reasons. Quarterback gets outside the pocket and panics a little bit, and receiver doesn't make sure he's absolutely in an open spot. So there's a guy lurking, took the ball from
him. Yeah, so don't wave your arms, right, as a receiver if you're not wide open.
Got to know that you're open, otherwise.
And the Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is 2nd and long. Looking to throw. Jones. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it. And they will get the first down here as they move into field goal range as well, inside the 25. An unfortunate sequence there, trying to get points before intermission, but now the interception, and their opponents have a chance to possibly pad their lead.
Yeah, they had an opportunity there, and they weren't able to capitalize on it, and that's something that could come back and haunt them later. They're begging their defense now to keep them from scoring before the half ends.
They'll roll him out right. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Meanwhile, on 3rd down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after 3 plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
They got the interception, but very little movement after, and that forces them to settle for 3. And it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense, because they ran onto the field. It's what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you got to go put out the fire, and they did, holding them to a field goal.
So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend as we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report.
It's a new season, so both of these coaching staffs likely making plenty of adjustments after their first half of football. So for the call of the second half here in week 1, we go back to Brandon and Charles.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always to you and the gang in Orlando as we welcome everyone back in for quarter number 3. We'll see if week 1 fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they're on the short end of the scoreboard here. Charles, what adjustments, if any, do you think they need to make for the second half?
We're paraphrasing the gold medal hockey winning coach Herb Brooks. I just say you continue to play your game. Throw the ball. They had success doing it in the first half. So make sure you keep getting the ball to your playmakers, a little bit more to the perimeter perhaps. But above all, play your game.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn 1 here in this 3rd quarter. and two. Jones. That'll be caught by his tight end, Ian Thomas. And he will have a Giants first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Jones now on first down, finding Sterling Shepard for his first catch. From midfield now on second down, Jones. Now Jones is hit. He lost the football. The 20, 10. And he will take it on in for a Giant touchdown.
Yeah, baby.
Cam Akers, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Giants able to get this back within a touchdown. And now they'll empty the backfield here as they elect to go for two. They'll look to throw. They're looking for Higgins, but it is intercepted. Adrian Amos with a pick. And now look at him go. He's at the 40. 20. 10. 5. And he takes it all the way back. It's a pick two, if you will, as head play backfires in a big way. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Taken at the goal line. And able to get this out to the 25. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And maybe some renewed pressure on this unit following the touchdown a moment ago. It's back to a one-score game.
And because of that pressure, because it's now a one-score game, they know this is where you need to slow the momentum change, because otherwise that could overrun your team. You've got to be careful right here.
They'll go right back to Nwangu. 42 yards on the ground for him now as he's done that on 15 carries.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
Allen's throw is complete, and he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. Now it's Nwangu. And able to use his blockers to get this up over the 40.
You got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
From the gun, it's Allen. He'll buy some time right. And he nearly got the first himself, but it appears he's going to be about a yard or two short. He'll wind up getting 4 yards there on his own, but it also brings up fourth down. The Dolphins will send out the punter now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. Fair catch, signal for and taken at about the 15-yard line. It'll wind up just a 35-yard punt, no return. And the Giants' drive will start from deep in their territory with a first and 10. The Giants' offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And things are starting to move in the right direction. They get the touchdown last drive, then their defense gets them the football back.
Yeah, now they have a chance to get the lead if they can put something together here. And I'm eager to see how they decide to do it. Do they want to be methodical, or do they want to take the big strike and go after it right now?
5 yards remain on second down. Going right back to Akers. And the window closes quickly. He'll only get up to the 22-yard line. 5 yards on first down, but now just a 1 yard pickup there on second. Back to throw. Jones. They'll set up the screen here to Akers. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense,
Do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete. So, Charles, you talk about this head coach and his future with this franchise. Look, it's been a frustrating year, and I think we saw some of that frustration boil over at his weekly press conference earlier in the week.
Yeah, he's trying to say all the right things, isn't he? But he's heard the rumors. He knows what's going on out there. And right now, he is tired of having to answer the question, are you on the hot seat in every meeting with reporters? This week, he kind of said, I've had enough. And I don't blame him. He looks like a guy that may very well be out the door.
He'll get this to Akers out of the backfield. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
Oh, that's a big let off there on third down because you've got to account for the running back coming out of the backfield. They didn't, and they got burned, not just for a first down, but for big yardage as well.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Second down, they'll go with Akers again. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. We are through three quarters here on NFL Kickoff Weekend. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Just week one, but already plenty of intrigue with the games going on, and this one no different as we come up on a first and 10. A give running right is Akers, and he'll take this one down to the 36. Jamin Davis there to bring him down.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot.
They're looking for Higgins, but it is intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it. And the Dolphins are in great shape here as they take over at their 46-yard line.
Well, NFL quarterbacks have learned the hard way. You're not going to get Rich thrown against this guy. He's definitely too good. And this is now his second interception of the ball game. And if I'm running the offense, I've got to tell my guys, you've got to go work on the other corner.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. Another important fourth quarter series coming up. That last INT helping to maintain their slim advantage. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. 60 yards rushing for him now on 17 carries. Throwing on first down is Allen, sliding out of the pocket. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down. So the shotgun snap to Allen. Eluding the pressure right. They'll get this to Nwangu. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. Now a first and 10 at the 11. Here's Nwangu. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
Throwing on second and 8. Allen. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Trayvon Mullen. And the Giants are right back in this football game. When he went on the move there and started rolling out, I thought there was a window, but that window closed quickly, intercepted.
And sometimes, despite how big your arm talent is, you don't get enough on a throw when you're on the move as opposed to setting your feet and stepping into one. That may have been the case there, and the defense certainly benefited.
Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
Get ready.
Normally we're talking about a quarterback duel where they're matching each other pass for pass. How about the footwork in this where both of these guys running the ball well?
Yeah, they've mixed in the run game. You're exactly right. Now, both coaches might not like how much their quarterbacks have taken off, but another example right there of just good mobility. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Second down, they'll go with Akers again. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
On first down, Akers, and he'll take this one down to about the 40. Olivier Vernon brings him down. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. Still nine remaining on second down. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Now Jones on third down. That one taken in by T. Higgins. And he will have a Giants first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Here's Jones on first and 10. And that one complete once again to Higgins. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. Looking to throw again on second down. Jones. That's into the hands of Akers. Complete. A minimal gain there on the eighth play of the drive. Fourth quarter. Down to the final 2 minutes. And we've got a one-score game. So it's Giants football here as we welcome you back. They face a critical third down now, needing a score here in the late going. Toward the sideline, did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge, and that's good enough for a first down. They come up on a first and goal in most likely four down territory as they need a touchdown and the PAT for the lead. And he maneuvers his way down to the 3 yard line. And now we're going to get a timeout defensively. So another stop, 1:50 left in the football game. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. They'll look to run with Akers. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down.
And now third and goal coming up, the loss on second down. That just means this crowd's going to get even louder, and they'll get a little bit of extra help from the defenders as they exhort them to join them in the effort.
A big play, if you think about it right now in this season opener. It's third and goal. Now Jones. Forced out to his left, and he will take it on in for a Giant touchdown. Daniel Jones, a 3 yard touchdown run. And the Giants are an extra point away from leading this game. Now they can boot it through on the always important extra point, and then their defense has to hold up their end of the bargain.
And there's something that you've pointed out in numerous games that we've worked. Okay, the excitement's going on. Everyone's celebrating over there. Who's calling up the defense to make sure they're focused, because they still have some work to do?
A very important extra point there, up and good. And that is going to put him on top by a point, and it sets us up for quite a finish. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Pulls it in at the 13. And they will wrangle it down a couple yards shy of the 30.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
They practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. Flush to his right. Over the middle, complete. That's Ross. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Here's Allen. Flushed out right. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard. Now Allen, rolling to his right. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up 3rd.
Well, he strung it out as far as he could, and I like the fact that he kept his eyes downfield, but he finally ran out of time and room. But I'll take that over forcing it downfield and possibly having it intercepted.
And if you're thinking field goal from here, it's 48 yards. I think they'd like to get him a little help now on 3rd down and move it closer. He gets this complete to Cephas, and he is going to have the Dolphins 1st down by a couple of yards as they're able to convert there on 3rd and 1. And a timeout coming in. This will be their final one with 10 seconds remaining. So this one comes down to the right foot of Sam Sloman. Footing, obviously an issue in the driving rain. This one for the win.
Time, focus.
And this is no good. Oh, by a matter of inches, he missed it wide to the right. And this stadium just fell silent in a hurry.
Crowd was ready to erupt, weren't they? But guess what? That chance to win one here, to steal one in the final seconds, goes awry.
Down to a knee goes Jones, and that should just about seal it. So a victory here for the men in blue, the New York Giants. And with that, our journey begins, Charles. Week 1 in the books. Going to be a great season.
Oh, man, so much to look forward to. Isn't it nice to get a really good game right out of the gate? Preseason.
Gotta make the right decision, know it might be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see is good intentions, it's the cloud and hit is mad. You can never be a subject carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, pop up trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging. Moving careful every day is exactly how I play this. Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I'm pacing. I got choices, I'm getting opinion from so many folks. To bring the horses so I can get up away from all the noise. Too many people tell me what I should do, I take it and laugh. They not knowing if I mess up, I can end up falling flat. If I write a bad tweet, lagging in my whole street. If I give them what they want, then I'm gonna be broke in a week. If I tell my baby no, she might get it from the street. If I'm not tough on my son, he might grow up to be weak. What do I do? I'm new to having cameras in my face. What do I do to keep getting the love from my state? What do I do to keep the money coming in? What do I do? Writing it till I need another pen. Gotta make the right decision, know it might just be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see is good intentions, it's for cloud and hit is mad. You can never be a subject you carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, pop up trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging. Moving careful every day is exactly how I play this. Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I'm placing. Feel like Jesse Owens, cause I'm taking off with the race. Put the metal to his mouth, retain his tongue, hold the brace. But I'm all about the beast until the sucker hit a make. Oh man, eat man, your performance kinda shaky. I'm prepared for the fame, I like that cops, I'm really like me. But I'd be lying if I said I didn't cry at least once a week. Cause I'm so blessed with no stress, all the way taking off of me. Head in the clouds and I smile like no grandma watching me. My dream came true, I'm loving all these cameras in my face. I never knew that I would get the love from my state. Stay with the blue, always keep the money coming in. Ain't nothing new, writing it till I need another pen. Gotta make the right decision, know it might just be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see is good intentions.